trading is a battle between you and the market, and a new book that's set to be released shows how everyday people are beating Wall Street at its own game. Millionaire Traders is the name of the book. It's written by a frequent guest of ours, Boris Schlossberg. It gives you the ins and outs of how the best are making money right now. In fact, here to talk about the book is Boris himself, Boris Schlossberg of DailyFX.com. Also, Stephen Iko, who is a day trader who's featured in the book. And Boris, I want to start things off with you. Congratulations, by the way.
Great, thank you.
Nice to see one of our own succeeding in writing a book like this.
It was a lot of fun writing it.
You know, one of the things I've been wondering is we know day trading has dropped off. We know we haven't seen as much as we used to see maybe 6-7 years ago, but there's still a way to make money in this. What did you find?
Definitely. The guys who really stayed with it are the ones who are really making a career out of it. I think that was the interesting part. This whole book is about guys who grind it out day in, day out, regardless whether we have bear markets, bull markets, flat markets, volatile markets. And that's, I think, the interesting point is these are the guys who really made it a profession rather than just sort of a flash in the pan kind of a trade.
Anything else they have in common?
The one thing that was very, very common amongst all these guys, especially the equity and the futures traders, is they had a very strong interest in athletics. And they had a very strong athletic mindset. And I was trying to figure out why that was. I think the key thing here is this. It's not necessarily that they were good athletes, but they had, having an athletic mindset, they had discipline and flexibility. And those are two absolutely crucial factors to succeeding in trading.
Yeah.
And because discipline is really all about absorbing pain, right?
Right.
And that's what you really need to do to be a good trader, to control risk.
You know, Stephen, you are one of the traders that's highlighted in the book. You've been trading NASDAQ stocks since back in the year 2000. How do you do that? What are you looking for when you're trading?
I trade NASDAQ stocks off the NASDAQ Level 2, which is the screen that shows all the bids and offers in the particular stock that I'm watching. And I watch the institutional order flow in the stock, the bids and offers, you know, who's buying, who's selling, like is it Goldman Sachs, Morgan Stanley, and I try to trade off that.
And
go ahead.
You have a good record, too. How many days have you been successful versus days that you lost money, let's say this year and last year?
I'd say last year, out of all the days, I probably had about 10 losing days out of 250 in this year. You know, about the same. So I'm pretty consistent.
But how do you do that? There are a lot of people who would like to try and do that, but being able to come out on the winning side, not an easy trick.
No, it's not an easy trick, but, you know, I'm very disciplined, I'm focused, and I'm patient. And I wait for the trades to set up. I don't chase trades. And I watch a small amount of stocks, so I know exactly what's going on in these stocks. Instead of watching, like, a lot of stocks, you know, I'm watching a few, so I know every move the market makers and the hedge funds are making. And I'm right there when they're making them. And you know, I make sure that I'm the first one to get the news on that stock.
How many trades do you make a day?
I'd say about 250 trades a day.
Wow. You know, Boris, I'm sorry, go ahead.
No, I'm trading all day long. I never stop. I never get up. I'm just focused and sitting there. And, you know, it's a short day, so I can make it all day and just stay focused.
You know, he says it's a short day, but imagine sitting 6.5 hours straight glued to the screen. It's a very tough game, and that's what I mean about discipline.
Is that what you did as a trader, too? Like, don't move from the screen?
I wish I had that kind of discipline. I think that's why Steve and some of the other guys were so much more successful than me. I think it's very hard. You know, I'm ADD. I like to get up every 5 minutes.
And walk around.
Yeah. These guys really, you know, devote themselves completely. It's a very almost monastic existence. But that's what it takes to succeed, and that's why these guys are so good. And I thought it was fascinating to tell their story. Stories in the book.
Yeah, you know, Stephen, we have seen a lot more volatility in the markets. Does that make it easier or tougher to do your job?
For me, the volatility is great. I love the volatility. The moves are extended. You know, when there was low volatility, a stock would move 10 cents and stop. Now a stock could go a dollar or two without stopping at all. So the volatility was great. August was actually my best month in about 6 years, and the volatility hopefully will stay.
And Stephen, real quickly, how much money have you made, let's say, since you've been doing this or over the last year, if you've got some measure we can kind of take a look at?
I've made a good amount of money, let's just say that, several $100,000 a year.
Okay. You know, Boris, while we have you here, we can't help but ask you about the currencies. You know, dollar, again,
yes,
looking at a 15-year low against a basket of currencies.
I know.
What's going on?
I mean, the bottom line of the story here is everybody thinks the Fed cuts and the ECB may raise. That's the story in the euro dollar. But if you notice, dollar yen is rising. We're actually been long Dalian for the last couple of days because we're betting on the fact retail sales may not be so bad, equity market stabilizing. So, you know, jury's still out. I really think, as everybody's saying, it's going to be very, Fed is going to be dragged kicking and screaming to have to cut rates, given the fact we got 700 gold and $80 oil. So we'll have to see whether it goes to 140.
All right. Well, Boris, thank you for coming in today. Congratulations on the book. It's called Millionaire Traders. And Stephen, thank you for your time today. Appreciate it.